welcome to the John Cass Cooking School here at the Chicago Tribune. I've been asked to do some beer can chicken, and I've given it my own little touch. I've taken out the wood chips and a little bit of the South, the Arkansas flavor, and I put in some Southern Greek flavor, okay? Here we have two Bell and Evans free-range chickens from Casey's Market in Western Springs. And we're just gonna soak them in a little water, a little bit of vinegar, and kosher salt. Usually you wanna let these settle and brine them with breast side down in a bag in the refrigerator for about, let's throw a little more in, for about an hour, for about 6 hours or so, or maybe even overnight you could do it. Now that you have the chicken dried off, first thing we're gonna do is we'll do it the easy way with my favorite Greek seasoning, Cavender's. So first we take a lemon, we lemon up this chicken really well on the inside and the out, rub it all around, get every bit of the lemon you can, cut it up a little bit or spread it out like this, and just rub it all over, inside and out. And then we take a little olive oil. My friend Wings, who helps me with the column, is opening the olive oil now. How about a tablespoon of olive oil? All right, and we'll oil up the chicken. Make sure we get the tips of the wings, even though we're gonna fold those in. They say put in about a tablespoon of rub inside the cavity. And don't worry, because this will not taste like beer. When I first started writing about beer can chicken, all of a sudden all these gadgets came out, like beer can chicken holders, and I didn't even get a penny from them, which really upset me. But also, you don't need them. You use real beer. My favorite one is Hams, the beer refreshing. You pour out precisely a quarter of the beer, and you drink it. Make two little indentations on the top of the beer can. See where I'm going here? And now we'll pour a teaspoon of the rub, whatever you use. Now watch, this will foam up. If you ever did a fourth grade science experiment, you put that in the beer, let it sit for a little bit, it'll foam up. You do not want to bend the can, you want to gently insert it into this beautiful Bell and Evans free-range chicken. Now we fold the wings in behind. And this is how they set up on the grill, do you see? They set up on the grill exactly this way, tripod. We're using a standard Weber kettle, but I'd like you to see this. I'm sure many of you know this. This is a little added option. You can buy these hinged grates. They're excellent for continuing to add coals. You don't have to lift everything off. It makes things a lot easier. What we have here is a regular fire starter, an old one. Actually, this is mine from my house, and it's all rusty, but it works. All right, here's why I love this hinged grill grate. It cuts down on the time. Cuts down on the time, and it's perfect for what we're doing. You don't have to take, you can, and we're gonna be adding coals periodically as necessary. Now you see how we're setting it up? It's a tripod, nice and firm. Won't tip over, let's hope not. If it does, I'm gonna kill myself. So we have them set, you don't want them touching. Now we take the top, this always has to be open. See how we're doing it? And just cover. Some people have called me up and said, the beer bottle broke. Or the can exploded. How many times do I have to say, open the can, use a can, not a beer bottle, okay? What we've got here is the beginning of a too fast cook. I had too much fire on and I had it open. This is the first time I've used this grill. Even though I've used this particular grill, it's already cooking too fast. So what I've done is I've taken it, shut the fire way down, okay? Taken off coals and should be cooking pretty good, even though the legs and wings will be a little bit too crispy. Now, are we done now, barbecue boys? What do you think? Where's my fork? Are we done here?
Yeah. Yeah, we're good.
We're good, right? You push this through. Hold the beer. And lift it up. I've never been so nervous in my life. Even when I met Barack Obama and the first time Mayor Daley got mad at me, I've never been so nervous cooking and then having Mr. Daley, who's not related, try to pair wines with my beer can chicken.
It's really good, the chicken.
All right, so what kind of wines are you trying and how
well,
do you do it?
Well, we have a sort of a broad spectrum. We have still whites, these are Chardonnays. We have two sparkling wines, two rosés, and two Pinot Noirs. And I think that pretty much is what most people are going to have in their liquor cabinet. So we want to see which one really works best with the chicken and that the chicken works best with the grill. So everything gets a little perk and a lift up.
What do you recommend so far?
Well, I just tried one wine with the chicken, so I'm not sure yet.
Actually, my recommendation for beer can chicken and barbecue is beer or Dr. Pepper on ice. What do you think of about the subtleness of the Dr. Pepper versus sort of the hoppiness of the beer when we're dealing with this kind of food?
Well, I suppose that you probably would want to stick, beer would be very lovely because it's been sort of seasoned with beer and has the beer notes. I've always enjoyed Dr. Pepper very much, but I do know some people complain that it has a certain laxative component to it. So you got to be careful. You got to be careful where you're eating and drinking that stuff.
Anyway, this is it now. So I hope you enjoy your beer can chicken and Bill Daley's recommendations and the panel's recommendations for the wine for it. And of course, I'll write about the other vintages that you should enjoy with beer can chicken and all barbecue. Thanks, Bill.
Thank you.